G'day everybody, welcome to another photo tutorial. This week I'm going to show you how to create this futuristic racer that I have on the screen now. We're going to do this in two parts. We're going to create the racer first and then add the racer to the background. So this is inspired by all those Star Wars movie racers. So as usual, let's get started. We're going to start off with the picture of a plane engine here, and this is the picture that I used, and all the pictures and photos that I use will be in the links in the description for you to use and try yourself. So I've already cut out the plane engine using my selection brush tool, and I've just got my engine cut out right here. And the first thing I'm going to do is just turn that engine around. I'm just going to hold shift key down and just turn it around so it's facing this way and nice and straight. I might make it a little bit smaller and just put it in the middle here. So I'm going to also use part of this motorbike, and I've just again used my selection brush tool, and I've just cut out the handlebars and this visor here. And as you can see, I've just got it cut out here. I'm just going to use this part of the motorbike here. I'm just going to use my Command C to copy it, come over here to my plane engine and Command V. Going to move it underneath the engine here and just bring it up and resize it. And I only want to see sort of the handlebars here, so I'm going to move that down, just resizing it as we go, maybe to about there. Looks pretty good. So on my plane engine here, I'm going to add a mask. Clicking on the mask, come over here to my brush. My brush, I'm going to pick a nice soft brush. The color should be black, so I'm going to hit X on my keyboard to swap those colors. My flow is at 25%, which is pretty good. And I'm just going to zoom in and make my brush a little bit bigger with my left and right bracket keys. And I'm just going to just fade that into the engine a little bit here. Get rid of those lines. Okay, that looks pretty good. Just make that a little bit smaller with my Command minus. At this stage, I'm just going to highlight both. Hold my shift key down. Come up here to my move tool. I'm just going to make that a little bit smaller to give us a little bit of room to move. Okay, Command 0. So we're going to bring over the exhausts now, and this is the picture that I used for the exhausts. And again, I've used my selection brush tool and I've already cut the exhausts out, so I just have to Command C back over to my plane engine picture, Command V, and I want that right in the middle there, so that's fine. I'm just going to turn this round, make sure we're on our move tool. I'm just going to turn that round a little bit. I'm going to bring it down here and we can resize it. I'm going to fit that in there like an exhaust or some sort of part of the jet racer. So about there looks pretty good. So I'm going to copy that now with the Command J. Come up here to Arrange and flip horizontal. And I'm going to move this one over this side. And that looks pretty good about there. Okay, so we've got our exhausts in place. I'm going to highlight them all again. Just hold my shift key down. I'm just going to move them all up a little bit now. Give us a little bit of room to move. Okay, that looks pretty good. So now I'm going to make it all look a little bit rusty. So I'm going to come over to this picture here of this rust. I'm going to copy that over with the Command C, come back to my plane racer here, and right on top I'm going to paste that one and resize it. Just double clicking on here so we can resize it. Command 0 to get back to normal size. I'm going to have 4 copies of this, so I'm just going to create a few more copies with Command J and turn off these 3 here for now. This one I'm going to clip to my plane engine. I'm going to change the blend mode to multiply. I'm just going to move that into place. We can stretch it out a little bit till you like where it looks. And that looks pretty good. So got some rust on our engine here. I'm going to turn another one on and I'm going to clip one to each of these exhaust pipes here. So that one there, again, change my blend mode to multiply and then just move it into where you want to see. And that looks pretty good. So I just move that. Okay, I'm happy with that. So that's the first exhaust. I'm going to turn another one on and clip it to the second exhaust. Change the blend mode to multiply and add a little bit of a different area on this one. That looks pretty good. And on the last one here, I'm going to clip it to the motorbike. Let's clip that, change the blend mode to multiply, and you can move this, stretch it anywhere you like. And That looks pretty good, giving that racer a little bit of age. Okay, so we're ready to bring over our racer. So I've used this picture of the motorbike here, and I just wanted the man. Again, I've used my selection brush tool to cut the man out, so he just looks like this. So I'm gonna go Command C back to my racer, and I'm just gonna click on the background here and paste our motorbike rider in, and I can resize him. And I actually want him right underneath. So we've got him looking right behind that racer there, and resize. Let's have a look how that looks. Not looking too bad at this stage. I might just highlight all my racer parts and just make my racer a little bit bigger. Okay, that looks pretty good. And then on the motorbike part here, this layer here, I'm going to add a mask. Clicking on my mask, going to grab my brush. I've still got a soft brush, 25% is still good. We want to be painting in black, so I'm going to hit X on my keyboard to swap those colors again. I'm going to zoom in on each of the hands here, and I'm just going to bring his hands over onto these handlebars. Okay, I'm just going to switch over to white, make my brush a little bit smaller, and then just fix that up a little bit. Okay, let's come over to the other hand, change over to black again, make my brush a little bit bigger, and let's bring our other hand in here. Again, back to white, fixing that up a little bit. Might have his fingers behind the brake there. Back over to white, make that brush a little bit smaller and just fix up these areas. You can take a little bit more time than me, I'm sort of rushing this a little bit. So there we have our completed racer, and if you just want to grab all of these different parts that are already cut out, I'm going to provide this file, which is a PNG file, on the Buy Me a Coffee site, and all you have to do is use your rectangular marquee tool and you can select each of these parts, copy them, paste into your own picture. As I said, they're already cut out. If you just want the completed racer, I've also got a completed racer as a PNG file that you can just grab and copy and paste straight into your picture if that's what you would like to do. Both of these will be available on the Buy Me a Coffee site. So let's get on to part two, and we can add our racer into our background. So as usual, let's get started on that now. Okay, so now we've got our racer complete. I'm just going to come over to here and, holding my shift key down, select all of those layers and Command G, and I'm going to call this racer and hit enter. Now it's time to get our background sorted out that our racer is going to go into. So I'm going to start off with this picture here, and this is going to be sort of our future background. And I'm going to come over here to this picture of our city with all the neon lights. I'm going to copy this over with a Command C, coming over to this picture here and Command V. Let's make this a bit smaller because I want to come over here to my move tool. I'm just going to stretch this picture out so I can't see the people's heads anymore. So just keep stretching that out. And on the blend mode, we're going to change that to screen. Command 0, make that a little bit smaller. We've got our picture here. So on my background picture here, I'm going to come down here to adjustments and pick selective color. Now I've picked this little tip up from a Photoshop artist called Phase Runner. I'm not sure if you've ever checked out any of his videos, but he is an amazing composite artist. So I've picked up this little tip especially for blending objects into a nighttime setting. So I'm going to just on my cyan here, turn this up to 35 and bring my yellow down to about minus 20 on this one. Clip off that, and this one's very subtle on here, but it just helps blend that in to that nighttime setting a little bit better. So now that we've got this all set up, we're going to bring over our racer. So I'm going to copy the racer, Command C, come over here to our setting, and right on top, Command V. I'm going to turn it a little bit and then just resize my racer, bring him down right in the middle here. Okay, again, I'm going to use that selective color, and you'll see a big difference on this one. So let's come to selective color again, clip that to our racer group. Again, our cyan up to about 35, bring our yellows down to about 20. Now let's have a look at that. can see the big difference. It's really helped blend that picture into that nighttime setting. Okay, so we've got our racer in place. So what we're going to do now is come over here to this picture of the jellyfish. Yes, very strange, I know. Let's copy that over, Command C, and let's paste that above our racer, Command V. Double click, and let's resize that. About that size is okay. Command 0 to get back to our normal size. I'm going to change the blend mode to screen. And then on my jellyfish here, I'm going to come up here to filters, distort, and twirl. And I'm going to twirl that all the way up and hit apply. Making sure I'm on my move tool, I'm just going to resize that. Bring it over to where my engine is. I'm going to turn it around a little bit right in the middle here. While I'm here, I'm going to grab my smudge brush, going to bring the strength up to about 20% on that twirl layer. Make my brush a little bit smaller, and I'm just going to smudge that twirl a little bit. And while I've got my smudge brush, I'm going to come down to my racer, to my aeroplane engine here, and I'm just going to smudge that a little bit as well. That is looking pretty good. So the next thing we're going to do on our racer is we're going to add some highlights. So I'm going to come down here to my racer, clicking on my racer here. I'm going to come down here to exposure to start off with. And I'm going to turn that all the way up, and then I'm going to command I to invert it. I'm going to clip that just to my racer layer, clip off exposure. I'm going to grab my brush. I'm going to turn my flow all the way up to 100%, making sure I've got a nice sort of soft brush. The color is going to be white. Make our brush a little bit bigger. Now we're going to add some of those highlights. Make sure that flow is 100%. The light's all coming from the back here, so we're going to add some light to our racer here. Make my brush a bit smaller. Command 0. So what we're going to do now on our racer, come over here to our live filters and come down here to field blur. And on that one, I'm just going to bring that up, and we can put a little mark here to where we want it to blur a little bit. Let's bring that up a bit bigger. Command 0. Just going to put that right on the edge of the helmet there, and then just bring this up. You can see it start blurring, but we don't want it. We only want it a tiny bit, just until it starts. And that's just sort of simulating a little bit of that movement that is coming in. So that's pretty good on that filter, so I'm going to leave that at that. I'm going to add a couple of lights down here on this little part of the engine. And I'm going to use this little ellipse tool here. Just draw out a circle. And I'm going to make the color red. I'm going to add a Gaussian blur down here on the live filters. And blur that till it blurs about like that. That looks pretty good. Make sure I'm on my move tool, clipping on that ellipse, and I'm going to add that down here to these little inlets here. And I'm going to add another one, Command J, and I'm going to change the color of that one to maybe green, and bring that one over to this little outlet here. And again, Command J, and I'm going to change that color maybe to yellow and move that one over to that little outlet there. Okay, very small little detail, but I think it looks pretty good. Let's go down to here. Next thing I'm going to do is come over to this picture, Command C, back to our picture here. And so just on the background picture here, I'm going to click Command V because I want it behind my racer. Going to come up here and change the blend mode to screen. Again, I'm going to come up to filters and go distort, and we're going to use twirl again and bring that up all the way and hit apply. Also going to come to my live filters down here and add another Gaussian blur, and I'm going to blur that just until I see it blurring. Looks good about there. And make sure on our move tool, I'm going to put that all the way over the picture here. Stretch it out, looks like some sort of vortex that he's creating behind him. And we're going to add our flames now. So let's come over here to our flame, Command C, back to our picture here. Again, right on top of the racer here, we'll go Command V, double click, and we'll resize. Again, I'm going to change the blend mode to screen. resize it, and I'm going to turn it around, place it where I want to place it, just coming out of these exhausts here. Going to add a recolor as well to that, so recolor, clip it just to the flame, and I'm going to turn my flames blue. Going to copy that one, Command J, come up to arrange and flip horizontal and move one of the flames over here. Okay, on each of these flames I'm going to add a mask. Grabbing my brush, I'm still on a soft brush, I'll bring my flow down to about 25%. Bring our colors back to default, I'll hit D on the keyboard and X to paint in black. On our first flame here, just going to get rid of a little bit here, make it look like it's coming out of that engine there. Changing over to white. Okay, let's do the same on the other engine. Let's add a mask, or I should say exhaust. Still painting in black here, and we'll just take away a little bit of that. Okay, let's go Command 0, make it a little bit smaller. It's not looking too bad. Let's bring all of these layers together now, clicking on the top layer, holding shift down, clicking on the bottom layer. Let's come to layer and merge visible. And on that top layer, I'm going to come up here to the develop persona. On basic, I'm going to bring up my clarity quite a bit and my contrast down a little tiny bit. On the detail, I'm going to put that up to 50. And amount 50, around about 50, and add a little bit of noise, maybe 10. And I might come back to basic and just bring that exposure down a little bit. So there you go, everybody. That is my tutorial this week on my racer inspired by those Star Wars racers. I hope you have enjoyed the tutorial. If you have, please give me a thumbs up. Please consider subscribing to my channel. Don't forget to hit that notification bell so you know when I'm uploading my next video. If you would like to show your appreciation, you can head over to the Buy Me a Coffee site. Also, while you're at the Buy Me a Coffee site, don't forget you can grab this completed cutout racer parts absolutely free, or you can just download this racer PNG file absolutely free from the Buy Me a Coffee site. So until next time, everybody, I'm going to say to you, stay well, stay safe, and I'll see you in the next video.